Don't have a Mac but still want to develop iOS apps? Watch this video. Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and I want you to subscribe to the channel because in this video I will show you how you can build iOS apps on Windows. Now, there are a lot of ways that you can develop iOS apps on your Windows computer, but most importantly, what you have to know is that you can develop iOS apps only with the help of Xcode. So Xcode is the way to go, and Xcode is basically a Mac OS app. It is an integrated development environment, IDE, for developing software for Mac OS, iOS, iPad OS, watchOS, and tvOS. That is necessary. You have to have Xcode installed on your computer. Now, how do you install Xcode? Because Xcode runs only on Mac OS. And that is the huge disadvantage of, well, it's not a disadvantage, but you can't really run it on a Windows environment. Now, what do you have to do? You have to create a Mac OS environment on your computer. Now, here are some things to consider. Are you willing to spend some money on this, or are you willing to spend some time and maybe some frustration and some learning to do this for free? Now, I will go through, first of all, the paid versions, and then I will go through the free versions. Now, first things first, let's see. You can rent a Mac for yourself. Of course, you could buy a Mac, but yeah, you already have a Windows PC. So you could rent a Mac, and that is basically running a Mac in your browser. And there are quite a few choices here that you can make. I have linked all of the links that are in this tutorial in the description, so go ahead and click that, and then you can download the resources. There's a list of all of the links that I have I'm talking about here. And what I want to tell you is that none of these resources are endorsed by anyone. I'm just telling you because I really like these services or tools. Now, first one is Mac Stadium. All of these free are, of course, paid, but there are, you have to choose which one you want to. Some of them are on a monthly basis, some of them are on an hourly basis, but you could just simply rent Mac at Mac Stadium or Mac in Cloud or Xcode Club. Now, what you could do otherwise next is just go and install a virtual Mac OS on your computer. Now, this is kind of technical, and VMware Workstation is a paid software, but VirtualBox is free to use. Now, you could just go to virtualbox.com, if I recall correctly, and just download VirtualBox, and then install it on your computer, and then run a Mac OS on your computer, and then install Xcode on that. So this is how you would go about that. Now, finally, you could just create your very own Hackintosh. Just go ahead and go to hackintosh.com, and you will have a bunch of instructions how you can create a Hackintosh for yourself. Now, Hackintoshes are really, really notorious to hard to build, but it has come a long way over the years. It's getting easier by the day. So that is how you can install Xcode onto your Windows machine. There are, I believe there are three ways you can do this. You could rent a Mac, you could have a virtual Mac OS on your Windows desktop, or you could build a Hackintosh. Now you know how you can build iOS apps on Windows. Now I want you to hit that notification bell, because in my next video I will be talking about iOS development versus Android development. Now while you wait for that, make sure to check out these videos as well too, because I talk a lot about Swift UI, Swift in general, and iOS development. And also, if you like this video, make sure to give it a like. It helps a lot with the YouTube algorithm. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.